This is the Jabberjaw Podcast Network.
Not everything metal was created equal.
What an ugly thing to say.
The Metal Sucks Podcast. Shiggity Chuck and Godless attempt to bring order to chaos or just make stupid jokes about dumb people.
Stupid. A person below normal intelligence.
This is the Metal Sucks Podcast.
Greetings and salutations, my fine metal friends. Welcome to another Metal Sucks podcast preview. How you doing? I'm Chuck.
I'm Godless, as are we all.
And this is your weekly examination of all things metal, the Metal Sucks podcast. But like I said, just a preview. In this week's episode, we got a ton of stuff. We're going to talk David Draymond because, you know, we need to talk about David Draymond. We got to have a talk, a little chat about things.
Well, it's about the rude lady texting in the front row of the balcony throughout the entire show.
So we'll actually hear from David Draymond himself on this episode. What? No, for real. Also, Dez Fafara is going to be our guest this week, and we're going to hear a new song from Dez and get some cool stuff, some insight on a lot of the things that have been going on with Devil Driver, because they've had some changes recently, in lineup over the past year or so. And that's the first time they've really changed lineup since the beginning. And we wanted to get some insight on that and the new record and a lot of the other stuff that's going on with Dez. We want to talk about his adventures in his backyard because, he is kind of a working man who's got to build a fence and some other stuff, too. So we talk a lot
and
about
Dez
that.
Dez is not the kind of guy who, when you go, so what happened, he says creative differences. You know, he spells it out. This is what was going on. This is what, and that is such, I mean, for a fan, that's just such awesome insight. I mean, thank you, Dez,
Yeah, totally. I mean, well, and, you just can't, not everybody's as candid as he is. He's one of those dudes that is going to just kind of tell it like it is. And I like that about that dude. He kind of calls it as he sees it. And the new record really is an example of it. He calls us out for, asking about the title of the record as well, which is fun. I thought that was kind of funny, actually. Yeah, I thought he was going to hang up on us for just a second. But, when it's called Trust No One, you got to go, dude, who don't you trust anymore? What the fuck? There's got to be something there. It's like, I never ask about an album title or a song title or anything like that. But, this one is like, wait a minute, dude. This is obvious. Like, it feels like it's obvious. But, we got to talk to him. And you can get the whole thing if you are subscribed to us on iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play, wherever you get your podcast. Make sure that you include Metal Sucks as part of your podcast routine. Why? Because it'll make you a better person. It'll make you smile. It'll make you cry from time to time. You never know. It'll make you do something in your pants. That's almost guaranteed. So make sure you're subscribed to us there. You can find us at MetalSucks.net every Monday. You can find us on social media. I'm at Bearded Ape.
I am at Godless Speaks and Godless Speaks on Facebook.
So join the conversation, not just with the podcast, but around the podcast, because we want you to be part of it. Part of our Patreon, if you want to as well. Patreon.com/Chuck and Godless. Go there. You can support us, which we would appreciate. That nod, that vote of confidence makes us feel better about ourselves. And these days we kind of need it because I feel bad about myself most of the time. So, we talk about that in this episode a little bit and how ways to make myself feel better, which, that's a whole nother story. You got to tune into the rest of the podcast.
Yeah, we had to get into the fact that, you don't seem to want to spend any time with your family.
Which is bullshit. I don't know what you're talking about, man. It's just because I want to do like other stuff doesn't mean that I don't want to spend time with my family.
I'm not quite sure why you bothered with the marriage and kid thing. I mean, you're such a solitary dude. You might as well just have, gotten on the motorbike and rode into the distance.
I could do that too. There is part
can't
of,
do it now.
There is part of me that I used to do. I used to go walkabout from time to time. It was kind of funny. You just jump in the car and like, okay, fuck it. I got to get away from here for a day. And I just drive in a direction and just go for 24 hours. It'd be awesome.
If there were a pie chart of the amount of time that you spend, the family part of the pie would be just such a sliver at this point.
Oh, what are you talking about, dude? Yeah, but mine are smiling at home when I get home. They're happy to see me.
That's true. You got that on me, but I'm not, you know, not, I'm not the model, you know?
Hey, man, I don't know. We'll see. But it sounds like, you know, we're talking about dads, fathers, other stuff. Dez, one of the most important things to him is his family. And that goes without saying, because every time I've talked to him, he's always talking about the wife, the family, how important it is to him, and what that means. So let's get a little snippet of our interview with Dez Fafara on the Metal Sucks podcast preview. Tell me another story. Tell me another story.
Everyone has stories. What's a day like for Dez before, like, interviews get going and all that sort of thing, when you're not doing anything? I mean, because you're not practicing guitar. What do you do?
I write a lot. So I get up in the morning primarily, you know, my wife and I get up with our Great Dane and Doberman and cats and tend to have about an hour in the morning, just her and I kicking around, you know, drinking tea, smoking pot. And then from there, you know, either get on the treadmill, go to the gym, or, you know, do stuff around the house. I mean, I'm just a normal family guy. I got three kids. And so there's got to get to Lowe's and replace that light. And, the it's getting ready to be 110 degrees out here. So I got to stay in the gate. You know what I mean? She wants me to help her put in flowers. So, you know what I mean? Pretty normal for me at home, and I tend to keep it that way.
You seem like the kind of guy who knows his way around a Lowe's, because, like, I get lost, and then I feel intimidated to ask, because, you know, I don't know the difference between a 3/8 inch screw and a 1/2 inch screw, you know, all that sort of thing.
Right.
You seem like you're down with it.
I was raised in a construction family, so I was raised very blue collar. I mean, I was working on a job site at age 10, at age 9, actually, at my dad's job site. So I know what it's like to get up, you know, when the sun goes up and be so tired when the sun is going down. And it's funny, a friend of mine, he's a rancher in Texas, and we were having this conversation. He's like, you know why I like you? He's like, you can come out here and get up in the morning with me and do the horses, and you're tired like I am at the end of the day. It's like, yeah, well, no shit, you know? So, yeah, I'm no stranger to hard work or places like Lowe's at all, you know? You know? It's pretty normal here.
You can run a trot line, you know? I mean, that's what it's all about.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? That's it. That's for sure.
Does that work ethic make everything that you do as an artist have a better chance of success?
This has been like, for some reason on this record, this has like been a question with everybody. And I think
I'm embarrassed.
No, but it's a trip that now that question is what comes around. I guess it's maybe that I've been in here many years doing the same thing. It's like, and the answer is always like 3 or 4 fold, right? It's like not just hard work and belief in yourself, but keeping your nose to the grindstone and all of that kind of shit. But it's also, you know, keeping your surroundings tight with friends, keeping your circle close. I tend to really just hang out with my family and my kids, my dogs, and just a few other people. I tend to stay out of the bullshit of the music industry completely. Like, I mean, you're not going to really find me backstage tearing it up or out at the strip clubs. I mean, I had my day doing that when I was 20, you know? So for me, it's like all of those things combined plus having a family, it's like you have to succeed. I mean, if you're reading this or listening to this and you're living on your own, and you don't have a wife, or you don't have kids, or you don't even have a dog, like, you'll never know what I'm talking about. Like, you'll never get it. But as soon as you wake up next to somebody that you love, and I've been with my wife almost 18 years, and you're like, man, I got to make sure there's a roof over her head. Or, you know, you see your kids come downstairs, you're like, hey, I got to have eggs on the table this morning. Like, you know, or you're looking at a dog, a Great Dane that's a 200 pounder, and it's like, I eat $60 of food a week. Like, he needs to eat. Like, so you got to go out and work. So that also applies that work ethic, you know, but then there's the love of what you do. And so you got to love what you do. And anything I did in life, yeah, whether it be bricklaying, masonry, I mean, et cetera, I've always enjoyed it. I enjoyed aspects of that job. I enjoyed aspects of the job site. You know, at 3 o'clock, you're having a beer and you're done. You're not thinking about doing the wall the next morning. You're done for that night, you know, and for me, it was great. You know, my job now, it's like, I go to bed thinking about my job. I wake up thinking about my job. So, yeah, I think, you know, just all of those aspects, you need to apply yourself in life. You need to enjoy what you do. And I love music. I do love the road. I love truck stops at 3 a.m. It's like, you know, it takes a really rare person to dig that shit. Like, I don't mind going without a shower for a couple of days. Like, shit, like, I don't mind. And I love being on stage. Now, all the other things that go along with it, missing my family, my kids, my dogs, all the things we've talked about, or what used to be, you know, fights on the bus with band members, this stuff, like, I'm over all of that. I'm in it for such a pure purpose now that I'm almost feel like I'm doing my better work now than I ever did. And I think that's gonna continue for sure over the next 20 years with me, because I'm just in a headspace and I'm touching into something and I'm tapping into something, and it's pure for me. It's a pure source, you know.
Grab the entire interview at MetalSucks.net. You can listen to the entire thing. Hear a new song called Daybreak. You get a little snippet of it right there. You can also hear new songs from Architects UK in this episode, which I'm kind of in love with. I think you'll dig. I don't know. Do people listen to this podcast to get new music? I've had that comment a couple times.
We had a bunch of people on Twitter. I forget what song we played last week. Oh, I think it was Walls of Jericho. And I saw on Twitter, like, a bunch of people were like, oh, I bought the album because I heard the song. I had to, and I got to tell you, that Walls of Jericho album is freaking great.
It's good,
and
right?
That song that we played is one of the best, like, second songs we've played on the podcast, maybe all times. I mean, it was just, it's so good.
It's actually pretty good, because for a while there, we were having trouble, like, finding stuff that we both kind of agreed on that we liked there for our second songs. And then, like, right now, I've got, like, three or four in the pipe that I'm like, oh, okay, I want everybody to hear this song. There's some good stuff that's coming out right now. And it's not all just baby metal. You know, not all of it. You know, that though. Oh man, somebody called us out on the on last week's podcast about they ran the ad for the new album that came out this week, and they're like, "Well, do you really like the baby metal album?" And I was like, "Well, I don't. I hadn't listened to it yet at that point." And then as soon as I did, I was like, hit back on Twitter. I was like, "Yes, I fucking love it because it's actually good. It's really good." 4.5 horns that we gave it. I don't know.
You know? Yeah, that's what Metal Sucks gave it.
Yeah.
That's the only review I've seen of the album so far.
It's worthy. Like, my buddy actually listened to it too, and he hit me up like afterwards. He's like, my God. I was like, that is a production masterpiece, because it really is. Like, there's so much stuff going on that thing. But hey, listen cool. to that for this episode of the Metal Sucks podcast. Give you a song off that. As well as our fun humor about David Draiman and my barbershop quartetting. So, you know, good stuff right there. So subscribe, all that good stuff. You know where to get us. You can find us on the socials, at Bearded Ape on Twitter.
At Godless Speaks.
And, of course, Instagram, at Chuck and Godless, and Patreon.com/Chuck and Godless if you want to hit us up. So do so. We would appreciate you joining all of our feeds and stuff so that we can ruin somebody's show with us taking pictures at it and be rude to everybody else while we're doing it. It'll be cool. It really will. I promise. So until next week, I am Chuck.
I am Godless.
And this is another Metal Sucks podcast preview.
You've been listening to the Jabberjaw Podcast Network, jabberjawmedia.com.